Ryan. Hi, Alana.
Hi.
Yeah, if you can just mute yourself after
Yeah.
we're about to start. Okay, just sitting nice and tall. And feel the spine lengthening. Feel the breath in your nostrils. Or maybe a little longer than you normally breathe. So inhaling for five and exhaling for five, if you can do it. Great. And then inhale those arms up. And again, slow, long inhale. And slow, long exhale. Nice and smooth. And breathe in. Two, three, four. And exhale. Two, three, four. Breathe in. Two, three, four. And exhale. Two, three. Four. Breathe in. Two, three, four. Exhale. Two, three, four. Good. And then we'll go side to side. Reach down on each side. Perfect. And then back to center. And then we'll cross above the head and then squeeze those elbows in. Cross, squeeze. Feel those shoulder blades moving. Good. One more. Perfect. And then we'll go to the side. Just straight out to the side. Good. And then inhale, arms up. And exhale. Lie down your legs and do a forward fold. And then inhale halfway up. So you're coming into seated cobra. Elbows in, hard up. But you're like a little bit forward, right? So hinging at the hips and then lifting the heart, squeezing the shoulders back. And then hold it there for a bit. Good. And then exhale down one more time. And all the way up, reach up and overhead. And hands to your heart. And then we'll keep the hands together. And then you're gonna go lifting the knee and twist to that side. So twist against that knee. Two. And three. And four. And five. And sit. Yeah, try to bring that elbow to the opposite knee. Seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. Okay. And then let's go straighten your legs. Just straighten one at a time. Push through the heel. Two, three, four, five, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. Okay. And then we'll do some rocking. So sit close to the edge. Have space to lean back. Lift 2 feet or 1 foot. And leaning. Using the momentum a little bit. Rocking on those sit bones. Feel the core. Good. All right. All right, and then I'll do some stand-ups, sit-downs. Nice and controlled movement. Music. Oh, shoot. Right, and then let's sit up and start marching. Lift those feet off the floor. Move those arms. So move. Keep a little bend of the elbows and drive those elbows back and forth. Good. And then we'll go out and out. And push those arms out to the side. Good, and then let's go up and down. Up, down. Straight out, down. Eh, more, and then we'll go the rotation. And I want to do a clap. And then a nice big rock. So reach through the fingers. Lean to that side. Lift the heel. Rock side to side, nice wall stance. So your feet don't move, just lifting the heel. Lift those arms up. Good. And then we'll go down into a squat and you're gonna sort of flick those fingers open as you go down. And up, down until squat. Open those fingers and power up. Open fingers. Flip those fingers open and then stand up. Let's go back. Good, and then back to march. Right, then we'll be tapping, just a tap with the right foot. So you're gonna go forward, side, back, forward. You could hold on if you want, back, forward tap, side tap, back tap. Not a full tap, but a little tap. So my center of gravity stays over that standing leg. Good, and then other side. Left foot forward, side, back. Forward, side, back. Forward, side, back. Good. Nice. And then back to march. And then we'll try a little rocking. So you're gonna go shift the weight forward and back and then switch. So like this. Forward and back. Forward and back. You shift the weight forward and then right away back. Great. Good, good. And then we'll go side to side with the hips. So bend your knees a little bit. Side to side. And then circle. And reverse. Till we see the break of day. Better get yourself together. Good. All right. And then let's go. And I'm that jumping jack. So up, touching that one foot out. Good. And then let's do the nice big arm swing, the straight arm, little bounce in the knees. Side for a side lunge and then poke that elbow out. Elbow up. And watch out for that chair, Daniel. Don't you try to do the samba beat. And then let's do some back swimming, backstroke. Perfect, good. And then we'll just go down, sliding down, and then sliding back up. Let's go down again. You can slightly bend your knees, hinging at the hips, and then back up. Feel that stretch in the hamstrings. Good. Perfect. All right, so let's get ready for our dumbbell. You know what? I just realized I might not be. Oh, yeah, I am. You're having trouble, right? Not sure how to help from here, but so you'll figure it out. Okay, so the first one, we're just gonna hold those dumbbells and we're gonna do shoulder shrugs. So you're gonna lift up and down. Okay, so that's the first one. And then between each strengthening, we're gonna do a little jogging. So. Today's gonna be more aerobic as well. Then the next one is a deadlift. So just like we did now. So you're keeping your spine long. You're not rounding, right? So long spine. And then hinging at the hip, lowering maybe below your knees. And then back up. Okay? And then, yeah, well, I'll just guide you through as we go. All right, so first one, the shoulder shrug. Ready, set, go. Up, down, up, down. And make sure you're going also completely down. Okay. Halfway. A little louder, keep going, keep going. Ten seconds. All right, ready, set, go. Then a little rest. And then the next one will just be jogging. So you can do any kind of on the monkey spot or side to side or forward, front, back. Or just march rigorously. Ready, set, go. Get that heart rate up. Hi, Ella. Hi, Carrie. Way better, 15 seconds. Ready, almost, almost there. Two, and stop. Let's have a breath, and then next one, and a little bit, we're doing that deadlift. So lower those dumbbells down without bending the back, and then squeezing the glutes coming back up. Pull of the hamstring as you go down, and they contract up. All right. Next one, again, is the jog. But again, you could also to do marching or any kind of a little bit more aerobic movement that works for you. Or you can try going side to side. Stop breathing. Keep moving those feet. Excellent, and rest. Okay, next one. You're gonna stand in a nice wider stance, maybe a little bend in the knees. You're gonna go up towards one shoulder and down. So it's a little bit of twist, keeping the spine nice and long. I see you keep your spine long, so you're just twisting. Okay. Your core is engaged, you're really stabilizing through the back, through the core. Halfway there. Kind of like you're passing on some bricks. Good, and rest. Nice job. And then we'll jog, and then we'll do the other side. Ready? That's oh, another star. Maybe you can go back and forth this time. If that's safe in that, okay? You can be in spot two. Or just do march. Good job. So now we're doing the other direction. So you're going your right shoulder and then left hip. Okay, ready? Set. Go. Up towards the shoulder, down towards the hip. While you're keeping the pelvis steady, core brace. Your obliques are working hard. Yeah. 10 seconds. Yeah, try to withstand whole body rotation. So it's just an upper body. Good. Good. And then we'll jog again for a change. Ready? Set, go! Push for that vigorous movement. Just 45 seconds. Turn right up. You could always do something like this. Right, step touch. Jogging's not for you. 5 seconds. Ready, set, go. Okay, and rest. All right, so the next one. Okay, so we're gonna hinge kind of as low as you can, right? So possibly almost parallel to the floor, and then you're gonna go like that. So lift the elbows, lead with the elbows, up and down. And down. More engaged, long spine. Bend your knees slightly. Max Pisolante, Piso Music, elegante. Zumba. Good. Pídeme lo que tú quieras. So your chest is coming a little lower towards the floor. You're almost parallel to the floor. All right, and then rest. All right, so then we jog. Or like that, you could do this. Or forward, back, quickly, or jog. Heart rate up. Move those arms a little bit. 10 seconds. 3, 2, 1. All right. So the next one is a split stance. So you could hold on. If you want, you can hold on with one hand and keep the dumbbell in one. And now we're going to try to go down and up with the bicep curl. Both knees bent and straight. Yeah, so maybe you don't need to hold on. So then you go like that. Both knees bend. And you need a long enough stance. Get that knee a little bit lower. So feel free to hold on. Nice job, good. And another jog. To the end. Alright, ready? Let's go! Good. And rest. Now we're doing the other leg. Yeah. Down and up. You still have 4 seconds rest. Ready? Oh. Hands. Coming down at the knees. Keep the core engaged and chest up. All right, and rest. All right, and one more jog or less march. We'll just work a nice big knee, high knee. So really lift those high up. Left. Okay, let's move forward. Four seconds. Perfect. And then last one. We'll try to do the cactus arms. And so we're gonna go down and just up. Open the elbows. Open. Squat. Up. Close. Open. Squat. Up. Close. Open. Squat. Get those hips back. Ten seconds, last exercise. Very good. And you're done. Give yourself a clap. Nice. Okay, grab a sip of water. I hope everyone's a little bit sweaty. Up. So we're gonna move between plank and down, or you could be on the floor. That's a possibility too. So could be down dog, and then move forward into plank, or here down dog and plank. Shoulders in plank, your shoulders are above your wrist. In down dog, your shoulders are ahead of your wrist. Or engaged. Back and forth. Back or engaged. And then stay in that down dog. So you're pushing your hips away. There. And then lift your leg up. Shoulders are, again, in front of your wrists now. So you're kind of being pulled away from that chair. and hold that leg up. Good. Side. I'm pulling you by that leg away from that chair. Okay. And then maybe come a little closer. And we'll do this. So lowering the knees, stand up. Lower, stand up. Lower, stand, straighten. And one more. Perfect. And then up. Now come close so your ankles are under your hips. And we'll do the lift 10 times on each side. Lift all the way as high up as you can. And on switch sides, up to 10. So now we're gonna come down and we're gonna be in this position. So you're gonna be sitting with your hands behind you and legs in front of you. Turn off the music. Seated. All right, so safely come down. And then we're going to first just puff up the chest, sort of. So on the inhale, you're going to try to straighten the arms and lift the heart forward. So as you straighten the arms and you're rolling the shoulders back, your chest opens. And then release, okay? And then lift through the chest. And release. And lift. And release. Yeah, so you wanna feel some movement in the upper back. So here the upper back arches. And then here you're rounding again a little bit. And lift. And release. All right, and then we'll come onto our forearms. So you'll be in this position. You know, alternatively, if this doesn't work for you, you could lie down. We're gonna straighten one leg and then slowly lower down. Up and down, again, maybe 10 times on one side. So if you can be on your forearms, you're keeping that core engaged as you lower down slowly. And then bring that leg as close to your face as possible. And then down again. Good. All right, and then other side. And so as you do that, try not to completely collapse into your shoulders. So you're still keeping that chest slightly lifted, right? And then looking And then moving your leg. So you're sort of like pushing into your forearms to get a little bit of elevation in the chest. Good, good, good. And maybe your neck is getting a little tired. So let's come down to completely flat. And then we're gonna interlace the fingers behind your head. So you're lying on your hands. And then keep your knees together, feet together, and core engaged. And we're gonna do this side to side, but right now you're not using the arms, right? So you have to brace more with the core. So you're going side to side. Keep those elbows and shoulders in contact with the floor as much as you can. So your core works. I just sign. Perfect. And then back to center. And let's put that right ankle on top of your left thigh. So the knee opens to the side. Let's do this. But the knee pushes away and then comes back to center a little bit more. I don't know if you see it, but open it as much as you can to the side and then bring it closer to the midline. Open, close, open, close. So that right knee moves out and in. Good. And then keep it open to the side. And then try if you can lift into a bridge. So it's just one-legged bridge, right? So you're pushing the head pelvis up and down, possibly with that ankle up on top. If that's not doable for you, bring the foot down and do regular bridge. Let's see if you can lift even with that ankle up on top. Unless it creates pain anywhere in the body. Good work. Okay, and then switch sides. Put that other leg up. And first, just move the knee. So, knee opens and knee comes back to center. Good, and then open the knee to the side. Loose left with the hips. Bring toes. Or two-legged bridge. Nice job, good. Yeah, for this one, you can keep those arms down and brace yourself a little bit. Good, good, good. Okay. And then let's come back onto the back. And you can try first with straight legs. We're gonna do the roll over where you're clapping the hands together. But you're trying to keep, let's say the left hand stays in touch with the floor, right? And then you roll over to touch it. So you're not lifting that left hand off the floor to meet the right. So you're just rolling over, clapping on the floor. You try with straight legs first. If that doesn't work, Even bend the knees. I think it's a little bit easier. So really rotate over all the way. Yeah, alternate sides. Yeah, so go to one side and then the other. Yeah, that's it. All the way. Work those core muscles and the mobility. You need to roll over in the bed, right? Nice job. Perfect. Okay, and then back to center. And then let's hug in both knees into the chest and rock side to side. Good. Okay, so let's do a little bit of that rectus abdominis strengthening, which is the six-pack muscle. It involves a crunch. So if you have osteoporosis, especially in the upper back, and maybe don't lift the head. Otherwise, you can slide your hands up towards the knees, and then look up with the head as well, and then slowly lower down. And then lift and slowly release. And lift, feel that core convert. Slide those hands up your knees as you lift and then down. Nice, good. That's, yeah, if you need to support your head, that's fine too. Yeah, it strengthens the neck muscles too, as you have to like hold the head against gravity. But if it strains your neck too much, then you can support the head with your hands and do a few crunches. All right, good, good, good. And then rest again. As you're resting, maybe we can just move the feet. So you're lifting the heels, lifting the toes, lifting the heels, lifting the toes. You see my feet. Just rocking on your feet, basically. Lift the heels, lift the toes as your knees are bent. Just to stretch the ankles. Perfect. And then find a comfortable position for Shavasana. So relaxing, softening your body. You could keep your knees bent if that feels better in your back, or maybe put a pillow under your knees. And bring your attention into your feet. Into your right leg. And left leg. And feel your buttocks and the pelvis. Feel the belly moving with the breath. Feel the back. Feel your shoulders. Feel your right arm. Right hand. And left arm. Left hand. Feel your chest. The shoulders. Your neck. Feel your face. Feel your whole body. Take a deep breath in and slowly start moving your fingers and toes. And when you're ready, you can roll over to your side and come up to sitting. Perfect. Great job, everyone. I'll do our little intention setting. Feel free to join. May I be happy. May I be healthy. May I be mindful. May I have courage. May I have fun. And may I treat myself and others with love and compassion. And then hands to your forehead. as a reminder of the power of your thoughts into your lips, as a reminder of the power of your words into your heart, as a reminder of the power of your action. Great action of the day. Nice job. Have a great rest of your week. And I'll see you guys next week.
Thanks, Petra.
All right. Bye.
Thank you, Petra.
See you guys.